And there he is, and there's his new jersey as Jacob Trouba is heading to New York after six seasons, all with the Winnipeg Jets at a career-high 50 points last season, but he is headed to Broadway. And now we welcome in the new member of the Rangers, Jacob Trouba. Jacob, what's going on, man? What was your reaction to being a part of the Rangers now?
A little bit of initial shock, actually happened. I don't know. I didn't really expect it to happen yesterday. Happy it happened. Happy to be a part of the Rangers.
Yeah, you know, that's interesting you say you didn't expect it to happen yesterday. How did you think it was going to play out? Because, you know, really kind of took us all by surprise as well. I imagine you thought it was going to take longer.
Kind of had the deadline knowing that the draft was coming and that was probably going to be a factor. So I was kind of just thinking Friday was the day or maybe a day before. Was not expecting it last night.
And, Jacob, we know that there are some extenuating circumstances to you wanting to maybe get out of Winnipeg, get down to the U.S. But you can explain to us exactly what some of your motivation was in changing teams.
Just family. There are certain things that we decided, my fiance and I decided that in order to do things we wanted to do outside of hockey with goals that we have for each other and life together, it was just kind of a necessary thing we needed to do for her career.
Always great to hear when family comes to the forefront, Jacob. When we talk about what's going to happen now on the ice, if you looked at the Rangers roster and kind of see how you fit in with them and what you guys think you guys can do?
Yeah, they got a lot of good, young, talented players. Have some good buddies that have played there. I've talked to some guys who were there. Just being in New York City and being a part of the Rangers and Original Six team is pretty cool. And hopefully we can go in and kind of figure things out pretty quick and figure out where I fit in and how I can help and just go play how I play.
All right. Well, and we know that you're buddies with Brady Shea and you know some of the guys, I would imagine. But what about the New York area itself? Have you spent a lot of time here? I imagine playing in Winnipeg, you probably didn't get to New York a lot. What do you know about this area? Not much or maybe more than we think you know?
Not a whole lot. Never really been there on vacation or anything growing up. Just kind of when we were there on the road, one of my favorite places to go. There's so much going on and just life in general there is pretty exciting. So, I don't know a whole lot just from what some people have told me, but looking forward to getting to know it.
Jacob, we know it's been a whirlwind couple days here, lots of news upending your life and moving to a new city. But the next question us hockey people want to know is, but what about an extension? Because you have one more year in your contract till you're unrestricted free agent. Have you had any discussions like that before the trade, now post-trade, about extending your time in New York beyond the 1 year that's left on your deal?
Nothing really before. I don't think we got permission to talk before. Now they're talking. I can see myself being there for a long time, but we'll let Kurt and then figure out the contract situation.
How much will you be paying attention to Friday night and then Saturday with the draft coming up, knowing that the Rangers have a couple of top picks and, of course, one in the top five?
Definitely going to be interested. Just seeing what Patty did when he came to Winnipeg, high pick and the impact he had immediately. It's pretty drastic the impact the draft can have, especially having one of those top picks. So, that's exciting, and that's a big part of what they're building there.
And how about for you coming to the Eastern Conference? I would imagine the travel is something that will be different and probably better for you. What do you feel about coming to the East and playing in the Eastern Conference as opposed to life in Winnipeg in the West?
A lot less plane rides. I don't find it to be a whole lot different between conferences, style of play-wise. There's definitely tendencies when you play people more that you pick up, so I probably got some learning to do with some of the players I'll be playing against more. A lot less travel. That will be nice. There's a long plane ride to and from Winnipeg that we've done in the past, so it'll be nice to have some short trips.
More nights, fewer nights on the road, more nights in your own bed. It's very nice in the Eastern Conference, Jacob. I remember going from Arizona to Montreal. It was beautiful. Now, as you look forward, you're very excited, of course, but maybe just reflect back on your time in Winnipeg. You kind of grew up there. You had some great moments on a great team leaving Winnipeg. What's your kind of best memory, or what would you take from your time spent with the Jets?
A whole lot. I mean, like you said, I did a lot of growing up in the last 6 years. I mean, some of my best friends that will be my friends for forever were on that team. I mean, I played with Andrew Kopp since we were 10 years old, and somehow we've stuck together this long. So it'll be sad to see people, not see people as often as I have in the past, seeing them every day at the rink. But looking forward to meeting new people, being on a new team, new situation, just all that's just exciting to be about.
Jacob, last thing before we let you go. New York is known for food, so bagels or pizza, what do you want first?
Both.
Definitely pizza.
Well
good
done,
choice.
Man. Well
good
done.
Choice.
Congratulations, man. We're looking forward to seeing you with the Rangers. We'll talk soon.
Sounds good. Thank you.